scripture saying to us, keep growing in the knowledge of Christ. Our opening scripture comes from the book of 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 18. But grow in grace and in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. To him be glory both now and forever. Amen. In 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 2, Peter writes to Jewish Christian pilgrims in certain cities, and he says to them, as newborn babes, desire the sincere milk of the word, that ye may grow thereby. The word babes there is perphos, Greek, and it refers to infants, children. Peter was writing to infant churches and young Christians. They had recently given their hearts to Christ. But then there's another group of Christians described in 1 Corinthians chapter 3. The Apostle Paul called them babes in Christ. He said, and I, brethren, could not speak unto you as unto spiritual, but as unto carnal, even as unto babes in Christ. 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 1. The word babes in this case is the Greek nepios. It means one who can't talk right. He may be 20 years old, but he's not able to communicate correctly. He's unskilled, untrained, not mentally coordinated, in spite of his age. So, when it's applied spiritually, it's dealing with somebody who is a spiritual babe, one that's not cultured, even though he's been a Christian for many years. Such people can neither grasp spiritual communication nor communicate spiritual truths. Paul berated them, saying, I have fed you with milk and not with meat. 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 2. Milk refers to the elementary principles of the Word of God, the elementary doctrines of Christ. One who is a spiritual babe will pray and cry to God to bless him. If he were spiritually mature, he'd have known that God already blessed us with all spiritual blessings in the heavenly places in Christ Jesus. Ephesians chapter 1, verse 3. He hasn't grown to understand the mystery of Christ, that the day he was born into Christ, he became an heir of all the blessings of God in Christ Jesus. Grow in the things of God. Press on for more knowledge, for more understanding. Keep learning the word with an unquenchable desire to know the Lord more and have his glory revealed in your life. Please say this confession with me. Our God is great and greatly to be praised. There's no end to the awesomeness of his majesty. As I keep learning his word, his glory is revealed in my life. I'm constantly transfigured and renewed more and more in knowledge into his image. Blessed be God. For further study, please read Ephesians chapter 5, verse 27. 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 3, and Proverbs chapter 11, verse 9. For the one-year Bible reading plan, please read Luke chapter 24, verses 36 to 53, and 2 Samuel chapters 12 to 14. For the two-year Bible reading plan, please read Mark chapter 7, verses 1 to 13, and Numbers chapter 5.
Rhapsody of reality.